beatable Bobby. As the chin of beatable Bobby rings out, there's the swinging neck breaker, the prelude, Gordon, to the Alabama Jam.
He's going for it, and I'll tell you what, beautiful Bobby looks like he's going to surmount his problems once again.
Bobby up on top. Yes. Everybody, Tony Schiavone and Magnum T.A. ringside with the superstars of World Championship Wrestling on Worldwide. The Great American Bash, what a tremendous event it was. We're going to be showing you some highlights from the Great American Bash. But our main event this week is a six-man tag. What an event it is. They're going to try to collect the bounty on the Yellow Dog as the Diamond Stud teams with Barry Windham and Arn Anderson against the Yellow Dog, Beatable Bobby, and the Natural Dustin Rhodes.
There's been a lot of accusations about who the Yellow Dog really is. But we're going to find out today if he can be unmasked.
We have seen now, it happened right here on Worldwide, what transpired with Beatable Bobby and Stunning Steve Austin, the World Television Champion. Stunning Steve Austin is the champion, but we have to show the fans once again how he won it right here on this program about 3 weeks ago.
It was a hard-fought battle, but it's nothing that I'd be extremely proud of, but the facts are we got a new champ.
We have a World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. We're going to be hearing comments from Beatable Bobby and seeing the champion in action. Let's take you back, though, at how he won the World Television Belt.
Looks like he's going to surmount his problems once again.
Bobby up on top. Yes. Got him with the Alabama Jam. And now Lady Blossom is in. The referee trying to get her out, but no, Bobby sends him in. Nick Patrick is down, and now Lady Blossom confronting Beautiful Bobby. She got the claws right in his eyes. Throws him up. Oh, my goodness, he pinned him.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, accompanied to the ring by Lady Blossom from Hollywood, California. He weighs 253 pounds, the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. His opponent from Malibu Beach, California, weighing 231 pounds, Kip Eby.
All right, so Stunning Steve Austin became the World Television Champion less than a month ago, right here on Nationwide TV on Worldwide. And let's hear what Beatable Bobby has to say about that.
Steve Austin, I've told everybody before, I do all my talking in the ring, but I will tell you this one thing. We have a rematch scheduled, and I'm going to get my belt back.
Beautiful Bobby, a man who is determined to get that World Television title back, and he may do it at the Great American Bash on Tour.
Well, you know that World title carries with it a great deal of prestige, and Bobby Eaton is a veteran of many ring battles, but I don't think he's ever come across anything quite like Lady Blossom.
Well, that's a good point. He has certainly faced tremendous athletes, and look at this roll-up from Eby! One count only, and Austin got out of the way of that.
Maybe just a little too cocky there, you know, we talked about his quick rise to fame. Sometimes it's a rocket ship ride up and it's a quick fall down.
Got an elbow tie up. He goes right with the arm and gets a right hand to the face of Eby. Lady Blossom, of course, we saw how it happened once again as Stunning Steve became the World Television Champion. Arm drag takedown that time. Pulling right up on the arm. But it was Lady Blossom that caused the loss by Beautiful Bobby. And I've said it so many times, why would a guy as talented as Stunning Steve Austin rely on that lady to win matches?
Well, obviously he feels like he needs some ace in the hole. He must have some lack of confidence somewhere along the line. I haven't done any psychological profile on this particular athlete. I don't know a whole lot about him outside of his athletic prowess, which we view here each and every week in the ring. But this lady is definitely what gives him the edge because she is more than just a distraction. She'll get very active in the match.
Austin, snapmare takeover, and right to the chest he goes. Continues his assault. The World Television Champion. Certainly Beautiful Bobby is foremost on the list, but there's a lot of contenders for that World Television title. We've said it so many times, it really rings true here. You are really the hunted when you become the champion. You know as well as anybody else. And now, digging the claws, pulling with the hair now, getting involved once again.
You know, usually you see a pretty lady on the outside of the ring, you think, well, maybe she'll be a distraction. Maybe they'll use her to divert your attention somehow. But this lady will literally scratch your eyes out. And more than one opponent of Stunning Steve Austin's has felt her treacherous claws.
All right. A pickup. The stun gun. Using all of the weight of the opponent, Kip Baby, on the top rope, and he's not finished now. It's that stun gun that puts him out. Austin with a standing clothesline after that. Hooks the leg, and that is it.
Here is your winner, the WCW World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin.
Stunning Steve Austin with a stun gun. Got a tremendous win here, Mac.
Yeah, we watch him. We talk about excellence of execution. This man nails this maneuver every time. And I think this always has his opponent right where he wants him, but he always likes to add a little insult to injury. And this short clothesline was a coup de grace for him.
The World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. We take you to WCW this week, and we'll come back and talk about the Great American Bash. Involved just about every Great American Bash World Championship Wrestling has ever had, but this one was the best ever.
I've never been let down by the confrontations that we've seen take place at the Bashes, and this year was no exception.
Some big things happened at the Great American Bash. We were all part of it exclusively on pay-per-view. We're going to take you back just last week and what some of the things that happened, what actually happened at the Great American Bash. And then when we come back, we're going to have more action with the superstars of World Championship Wrestling, but take a look at the Bash.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following historic confrontation, it is for the WCW World Heavyweight Championship between the top two contenders. Introducing first, the number two contender from Sweetwater, Texas. He weighs 278 pounds, Barry Windham.
He may be number two in your program, but he's number one in the hearts of many fans that are here in the Baltimore Arena.
From Chicago, Illinois, weighing 292 pounds, he currently holds the United States Heavyweight Championship, the Total Package, Lex Luger!
As these thousands of fans look on, their ovation, quite evident that Luger will be the favorite in this contest. The United States Heavyweight Champion is the number one contender. He has been very active in defending the U.S. title, and he has not had too many opportunities in the last year or so, Tony, to wrestle for the World's Heavyweight Championship.
My goodness.
Kicked him in the face, and down goes Luger. Windham up on top, a big elbow, but nobody there. Windham went for an elbow off the top rope. Remember, he stands 6 feet six, but when he got to the canvas, that's all he found. Luger was gone. Backdrop, good elevation by Luger, and a clothesline. The big man now opening up on the number two contender in the world, Barry Windham. And coming down the rampway is, that's Harley Race on the right, Mr. Hughes on the left.
What's this all about?
I have no idea. Harley Race, a multiple time world champion. And Mr. Hughes, who is the bodyguard of the York Foundation. Now are they, what's the deal? Are they with Barry Windham? No, Harley Race
is over there talking to Luger.
Luger has won the WCW World's Heavyweight Championship with that Harley Race pile driver. And there's Mr. Hughes I'm somewhat baffled about their presence. Speaking of Hughes and Race.
You are looking at the new WCW World Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger.
The Total Package has got a message for the rest of the world.
That's exactly right, Harley. A shot heard around the world just moments ago. What we're talking about, there's no frivolity here. What we're talking about is a satisfaction and a job well done, a job long overdue. What we're talking about is the past right here has been forgotten. New history's being made. This is the dawning of a totally new era for the Total Package, Lex Luger. I have arrived. Get used to this face. Get used to this body, because there's nothing like it. The Total Package, Lex Luger, is going to establish a sphere of dominance this sport has never seen. Let this be a message to all wannabe wrestlers, all star wrestlers of now, all has-been wrestlers, because the Total Package, Lex Luger, has finally arrived. There's been an attitude adjustment, so to speak. Barry Windham received an attitude adjustment like any other wrestler who stands in my path. There's a new frame of mind for Lex Luger. The physical tools were always there. I just had to be made to believe in myself, in my abilities, and grab it by the throat. And that's what I did just moments ago.
Putting a man into a frame of mind is the thing that this man liked. It's there now. The Total Package is all together.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Argentina, at 7 feet, 7 inches, he weighs 454 pounds, the largest athlete in the world, El Gigante. His opponent, ladies and gentlemen, from Norway, 294 pounds, Carl Nelson.
Well, El Gigante not only is the largest athlete in the world, he may be the maddest. And he has some comments directed at the one-man gang.
One-man gang, you cut my hair, and you're going to pay for it.
What about this guy?
I think this guy is more intense than he's ever been. Talk about getting cranked up. At 7'7", I don't think he's ever had to do too many things he didn't want to do, and I'm sure he's never had a haircut that he wasn't planning on.
The big one-man gang, of course, I know, is looking on. And our good friend, 7'7", El Gigante, who's not the most pleasant man to be around right now, and you can see why, plainly. He's going to be in Los Angeles this coming week. He's going to be in San Diego, down in San Diego, and our good friends will be seeing him out on the West Coast. He'll be part of the Great American Bash On Tour. I want you to see it when it comes to your arena. And, of course, the Argentinian Giant, who made a real run at the WCW World title in the early part of the year, now is embroiled in this personal battle with a one-man gang. And for him, it's not a matter of who is the Giant in World Championship Wrestling. He just wants revenge.
Tony, you can look in his eyes and see it. He wants this now more than anything. He's got to prove something. All these people, all these fans that have been behind him all this time, they want to see him get his due. And the only way he can do that is to take out the one-man gang. And that claw could very well do it.
The intensity of El Gigante!
Here is your winner, the largest athlete in the world, El Gigante!
They are standing. They love this big giant. Who's like a wild man right now. And I tell you, Sullivan and the one-man gang better take note.
God, you're gonna pay now.
The largest man, the largest hands. When he gives you a vertical suplex, you're falling out of the 10th floor of a building. And when he sets you up for the claw, is Katie bar the door.
Wow, the one-man gang. You better be watching because El Gigante is back. A little bit less hair, thank you. But he's ready for action. And we'll have Ron Simmons when we come back on World One. We'll be right back.
Warner Robins, Georgia. He weighs 275 pounds. The All-American, Ron Simmons. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Northport, Florida, weighing 251 pounds, Bob Cook.
All right, Ron Simmons, watch out, Bob Cook, the Floridian from behind, going after this big guy. And let's hear, watch out here, let's hear some comments from Diamond Dallas Page and the Diamond Stud.
Good God, the Great American Bash is in full swing, and the Diamond Stud is taking apart World Championship Wrestling piece by piece. Ron Simmons, you know, you may have been a stud on campus, but you're nothing when it comes to the Diamond Stud. He's the stud. You're a dud.
Well, Magnum, you know, we have seen you had a firsthand talk with Diamond Dallas Page and, of course, the Diamond Stud about their attack on the Z-Man. Now they're trying to bark up the tree of Ron Simmons. They really have set their sights high in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, Tony, the way I see it, there's a lot of studs in World Championship Wrestling, and to claim the title of being the only stud is going to put you in a lot of bad situations. Now, I would really like to see a face-to-face confrontation with Big Ron and the Diamond Stud, because I've seen that scowl on his face, and when he gets in a bad mood, there isn't anybody that wants to be in front of him.
Armbar applied on Bob Cook, who tried to get an early advantage, which is not a bad idea, let's face it. When you got a guy like Ron Simmons in the ring, you try every advantage you can take, and Bob Cook tried the sneak attack. It didn't work, but that elbow found its mark.
Well, when you're going up against this caliber of athlete, and this is professional athletics, you have to do whatever it takes sometimes. And he knows that if it's straight up, he doesn't stand a chance. So he tried to take advantage of it, but it was very quickly turned around by Ron.
Arm drag takedown, and he's up with the arm bar once again on Bob Cook on the far ropes. Ron Simmons, who has made the transition quite well between tag team wrestling. He was such a dominant tag team wrestler during the bulk of 1990. And now into singles competition. I know he's thinking about titles. We have a big announcement concerning Ron Simmons coming up a little bit later on in this program, Magnum. We want the fans to stay tuned.
Ron Simmons is a man that could write his own history right as we speak. Everything's ahead of him. He's got all the potential in the world, and he's made that transition into the big leagues now as a single wrestler, and the sky's really the limit.
Some of the stops of the Great American Bash on tour this week will be San Bernardino on Thursday, the Oakland Coliseum on Friday this coming week, Phoenix at the Coliseum on Saturday, Nashville this coming Monday, just to name a few of the spots of the Great American Bash on tour. Catch it wherever it comes your way. And there's a drop right down on the arm. Ron working right on one part of the body.
See, he's getting some experience now. I saw when Ron first blew on the scene in his past matches, he was a high-impact wrestler, did a lot of really high-risk maneuvers, and now he's getting down to the basics, because if you see somebody that's really successful, they can really key in on these fine elements. They can find that one body part and wear it down, and that's the kind of psychology you've got to have when you're going against world-caliber competitors.
Right on the arm once again, Simmons pulling on Bob Cook. Of course, he's had his run-ins with the one-man gang of Kevin Sullivan and, of course, Teddy Long. But Simmons, who has been able to use his athletic ability to win matches, now the fans are behind him 100%.
Well, he's totally dominating Bob Cook. I think he's getting a little wrestling lesson where he said, you want to jump out of the chute quick on me, young man. He's going to punish him a little bit. I mean, he's giving him a little bit of a lesson here. He turned things around on real quick. But Bob Cook's got a lot of heart.
Reversal, pick up, power slam. Tremendous power. So effortless. Ron Simmons up top. Sidewalk slam. See you later.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner
when
of
we
the
come
match,
back, fans, the World Championship Wrestling Board of Directors Ron Representative Grizzly Smith Simmons will have a statement on the situation with the Yellow Dog and Barry Windham after this timeout.
This is Grizzly Smith of the WCW Board of Directors. The past couple of weeks, wrestler Barry Windham has claimed that the masked wrestler, the Yellow Dog, is really Flying Brian in disguise. To those claims, we have this response. Mr. Windham, until you bring me proof that satisfies the Board of Directors, no action will be taken. By proof, I mean basically unmasking the yellow dog and showing us it is, in fact, Flying Brian. However, if you can prove it is Flying Brian, then I must warn him of the consequences. You have been banned from WCW and are able to apply for reinstatement within the next year. But if we have proof that you are the yellow dog, then you, Mr. Pillman, will be banned for life.
From Macon, Georgia, weighing 253 pounds, Johnny B. Bad. His opponent from Baltimore, Maryland, 226 pounds, Jumpin' Joey Max.
I don't know, man. I don't know. He's too much?
Too much, you said? Too much? Yeah, he's too much, all right. Either Teddy Long is a genius or he's gone completely nuts. I'm not exactly sure.
Johnny B. Bad. He's so pretty. And, of course, he is light on his feet. And one thing about it is, he's very flamboyant, very extravagant, to say the least. But he is very temp. What's that?
I don't know what that was. I'm not even going to speculate.
Well, they touching fingers right there?
I think that was
the their version of the high five.
That was the finger shake.
Well, you could say this about him, that he really captivates an audience, so to speak. He really owns the ring when he comes in, and it's all part of the psych-out job on his opponent.
Well, talk about throwing up a smoke screen. If this isn't distracting when you come out the ring, I mean, the entrance, the air about this man. We talk about charismatic figures in the world of professional wrestling. Well, this guy is rewriting the book, but he is definitely a high-caliber athlete. I mean, these kind of moves, that duck under, turn around, putting the man down and dominating. But Joey Maggs, he's been in a few battles, too, and he's not going to take this line down.
Johnny B. Bad, tremendous upper body development. He is a great athlete, and of course, his main weapon is that left hand, which finds its mark. It is illegal to use a clenched fist, but it gets the job done for him.
But when you can get it done in one punch like he's been doing, there's no time for a warning. It can hit you like a bolt of lightning out of the blue, and there are many a man has felt the mark of that left hand.
They have claimed so many times that you should not put your hands on Johnny B. Bad. There's a lot of men out there who will say, okay, I won't. I'll be glad to. But the Rapmaster PNUs has done so, and it has sparked quite a controversy now with the Rapmaster and Johnny B. Bad.
Well, we've heard Johnny B. Bad say on more than one occasion that he thinks he's a big old ugly bear. He's talking about PNUs. Well, PNUs is a big 400-pound bad man. He's got a good rap, and he electrifies audiences all over the country. But this guy here may have bit off a little more than he can chew, because you've got to connect that punch, and doing that with PNUs may be a little easier said than done.
Full arm drag and twist. Fireman's carry takeover. Tremendous execution in the ring by the man from Macon, Johnny B. Bad. Light on his feet, great power slam right there.
And Tony, where did this guy come from? He doesn't impress me as somebody that came from the amateur ranks. I mean, he really, I have no idea. I'm kind of baffled sitting here watching him.
Well, you know, as a co-host here, sometimes you're put in the investigative reporter role. Why don't you go talk to him sometime?
I may just have to do that, but I'm going to look at him from a distance a little while longer first.
Don't touch him, okay? Keep your hands off of him.
Don't worry, I won't.
Up to the top. Sunset flip. We got a two count. Could have pinned him. Teddy didn't want it. There's the high knee, sending Joey Maggs down, the athlete from Baltimore. And Johnny B. Bad now dancing.
The shades of Muhammad Ali here.
And connecting.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Johnny B. Bad.
Now they're going to apparently plant the kiss on Joey Maggs.
The signature of Johnny B. Bad. We can call it like we want, but this guy has got all the right moves. Wrestling, running around, flaunting it to the crowd. He can do whatever it takes, but he always intimidates his man. The knockout punch was so quick, we couldn't even hardly see it. Once again, another one that bit the dust.
Your winner, Johnny B. Badd. Our main event is next.
Hi, kids. My name is Chip, and I'm the Firebreaker. And this is Todd Champion. And together, we're the WCW Patriots. And my partner this week has a special message for you.
You know, kids, in order to be a great American, you can't do drugs. You have to take care of your body and get plenty of rest and be the best patriot you can possibly be.
The following main event contest is a special six-man tag team bounty match. The bounty is for the mask. Introducing team number one, the chairman of the board of the Diamond Exchange, Diamond Dallas Page, presents at 298 pounds, the Diamond Stud. From Minnesota, he weighs 248 pounds, the enforcer, Arn Anderson. And from Sweetwater, Texas, 278 pounds, Barry Windham.
Well, I'm sure you heard the comments from Grizzly Smith, who said, if in fact we find out that the Yellow Dog is Flying Brian, and Barry Windham proves it by taking his mask off, that Flying Brian will be out of World Championship Wrestling for life. No reinstatement procedures will take place. And here's our bounty match main event, Gary Gapeta, take it away.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, first from Austin, Texas, 261 pounds, the natural Dustin Rhodes. From Huntsville, Alabama, 233 pounds, beautiful Bobby. And from the Kennel Club, 226 pounds, the Yellow Dog.
Bang, the object of wrestling matches is to win. This is a bounty match. And it's very obvious the objective of Barry Windham, primarily Arn Anderson and the Diamond Stud, is to take the mask off here. They might forget to try to win a match here.
Well, you know, Barry Windham has become obsessed with this Brian Pillman thing. I mean, he's going crazy about it. He's been a thorn in his side for so long that this is all that he can focus on. And you're absolutely right. Somebody could get all fouled up thinking about this mask and nothing but exposing the Yellow Dog for who or whatever he is and forget, and we could see a real upset.
Barry Windham will start out. It wouldn't surprise me to try to see Windham knock him out early and just yank the mask right off. Flying Brian did lose. A little seat. There he goes. He's going right for the mask. It may be early now, but he is going right for it. And the Yellow Dog fighting back. Once again, Flying Brian lost that loser leaves WCW match on June 12th. Since that time, the Yellow Dog has appeared. Tremendous maneuver. A slap right to the pectoral region. And the Yellow Dog sending Windham in. High back body drop. Now the Yellow Dog up top. Windham stunned. Watch out. Dropkick over the top.
Well, Tony, I'm not going to speculate as to who it is, but you got to admit there's a lot of similar maneuvers going on here that we've seen in the past, and you know who it was that was doing them.
Yeah, it was Flying Brian. Flying Brian was a high flyer in World Championship Wrestling. He liked to use the high-impact chops in the pectoral region. The fans are right behind this Yellow Dog right now. But the question remains, as Grizzly Smith said, if you think it's Flying Brian, then prove it, or we're not going to act at all. Over the top, the Yellow Dog. From behind.
This Yellow Dog is on top of his game tonight. This is going to be a hot six-man.
Fans are cheering. And the Yellow Dog, as we take a close look at him, he's really playing with the mind of Barry Windham right now.
I mean, talk about a little torment going on here. Mentally, I think Barry Windham is about to come unglued.
Beautiful Bobby. And the Diamond Stud in. Listen to him chant Bobby's name. Collar and elbow. Diamond Stud. The big guy had him captured. Bobby comes back out swinging, though. He would not back down or be intimidated by the big guy.
The Diamond Stud is going to find out quickly. He's got another stud on the list. If he's going to start talking about being the baddest, Bobby Eaton will stand in the middle of the ring and trade leather with anybody.
Beautiful Bobby, the man who wants to get that world television title back from stunning Steve Austin during the Great American Bash. In to help out the Yellow Dog in this bounty match. This is a bounty match. And that very frankly means that they will try to take the mask off of the Yellow Dog by defeating him. And if they do, then there's some sort of bounty, which I guess Barry Windham has put out available to his two partners here.
Oh, there is definitely money on somebody's head here, so to speak, because these guys are not playing for honor. These guys are playing for cold hard cash.
1 week ago, the natural Dustin Rhodes involved in a bitter situation involving the York Foundation and, of course, Robert Gibson. We have a big announcement concerning Robert Gibson still to come on this program. And right now, the Diamond Stud going right after the natural Dustin Rhodes.
You'd have to say that the Stud is going to get a newfound respect for some other athletes here in WCW, because this is the first time I've seen him connected up with Dustin Rhodes, first time I've ever seen him have a confrontation with Bobby Eaton. But he is finding out that there's a whole lot of fire in all these men.
Great move, Rhodes, pulling out of the corner when there was going to be a double team. A surge of energy right there, and he was in the right spot, or got to the right spot, I should say.
Well, he was in no man's land, and nobody can survive for long there, especially with the likes of Barry Windham, the Diamond Stud, and Arn Anderson in the ring.
All right. Anderson, Dick Beatable Bobby, and now goes after the natural, Dustin Shoochie Man. Outside. I think he may have forgotten about something here. Right here. Safest place is back in the ring. And Arn Anderson.
I mean, we just talking about being in the wrong spot. Arn Anderson got himself in the wrong spot and got peppered everywhere he turned around.
Well, they knocked the common sense right out of him, didn't they?
Now look at that bewildered look on his face. He doesn't know which ends up. Barry's going to probably try to settle this pace down a little bit because it's about to get out of hand.
Well, that's right. It is getting out of hand. Windham wrestling with emotion here, I think. Mag.
Sometimes that emotion can make you do some things that your common sense would tell you otherwise. Barry Windham, like you said, could be concentrating too much on that mask. And right now we got some young stallions out here that are content on doing some punishment of their own.
Windham escaped the head scissors. He was too close to the Yellow Dog, and that may have been a mistake. Some may say, if I'm the Yellow Dog, why not go ahead and make contact there?
Well, you know, you got to kind of play your cards right out there. Timing is everything in that square circle, and you kind of feel what's the right time to make the move. Dustin Rhodes has got everything well in hand. They're executing some good arm drags. The Yellow Dog's out there on the ring getting a much-needed rest. Now you see Barry Windham back in that corner, and he has become the human punching bag.
Right hands from the Yellow Dog, from Beatable Bobby, and now from Dustin Rhodes. Windham, dazed, on his feet. Here comes the Dog. Right on the pectoral region again. Wow.
I'm telling you, Tony, that's a mighty familiar looking chop. Every dog has his day, and the Yellow Dog is certainly having his day here tonight.
What are you trying to say here?
I'm saying the Yellow Dog is in his prime.
In comes Arn Anderson, who very definitely tries to slow the pace down now. And that's not a bad maneuver.
Well, somebody put an anchor around that guy in the yellow suit's legs, because he's flying all over the ring and thus far has been completely unstoppable.
Into the midsection, shoulder blocks. Reversal. Over the top. Single leg takedown. Into a figure four. Barry Windham and the natural are in. Figure four. Figure four.
Triple figure four.
Who's going to give up? Everyone standing in the arena. Wow, what a moment. And Windham, Diamond Stud, and Arn are hurt.
They came in here talking about a bounty. All of these guys could be looking for crutches just to get out of the ring.
What? I can hardly hear myself. What turned in for a bounty match, or began as a bounty match for the mask, has turned into a match where Anderson, Windham, and Studd are literally fighting for their lives here.
Well, the Yellow Dog and his team have definitely dictated the tempo of this match. I thought the Hood may be in jeopardy early, but thus far, these guys are showing the whole hand. They're dealing with whatever they want to do in the ring.
Bobby fighting out of the corner there. He's just too tough to get him pinned in. Chasing Arn Anderson, and this may be trouble here.
Yeah, this could be a bad draw. He's not in the right place. Oh. That's the kind of attack you got to look out for. Barry Windham has been a veteran down the road too many times.
Barry had taken a spill on the outside, and when Arn purposely missed, Windham, who was crouched, attacked him. And I tell you what, Magnum, it was a great team maneuver.
Well, they drew him around. I mean, it was the old sneak attack. We've seen it so many times. But you have to set it up properly, and that's where that timing comes into play. These guys don't care how they get it done. They just want to get it done their way.
Fans are chanting with Bobby. Catapult in the bottom rope. Can Bobby, the former World Television Champion, come back here? Look at that, Barry Windham with a knife edge. And now Bobby. That time his jaw hit the security rail on the far side.
Tony, that's what makes these contests so exciting. I mean, just that quick, the tide of battle can be turned. Bobby Eaton now in a lot of trouble, and he's in the wrong side of the ring. So look at Dallas Payne get involved in this.
Send him to the security rail also. So basically, all four men have had their shots at beatable Bobby. You know, his high-flying maneuvers certainly work on the back, and that's what they're doing, trying to hurt the back even further here.
They're, without a doubt, they're hurting the arsenal of Bobby Eaton. He needs to make his way over and make a tag and get one of those men in the ring that isn't in a bad way like he is.
Right hand. Fans are still standing everywhere here. Tremendous crowd on hand for Worldwide as you take a look at our six-man battle. Bobby trying to get in the corner. Arn Anderson continues the assault. Yes, sir. Right on target again.
Arn Anderson, the master of tag team wrestling, cutting the ring off there and getting Bobby down, but down in his corner because he knows positioning is everything.
Windham, right to the face. Bobby in the neutral corner. Dustin trying to go over and give the man a hand here.
Eaton has taken some terrible punishment. If he doesn't get to the corner soon, this match could be over.
Windham drives it in. Look at the Bobby fan. But can Bobby come back from this assault? All three men, Diamond Dallas Page, in this bounty match for the mask of the Yellow Dog, have attacked beatable Bobby. But can he get to the corner? Yes. Dustin. Going after all three. All six are in. Dustin is the legal man, and he's on the outside. Yellow Dog trying to leapfrog. He's going to scoop up Arn Anderson.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of beautiful Bobby, the Yellow Dog, and Dustin Rhodes.
They're going for the mask.
Tony, as we said, this match wasn't about winning or losing. It's about getting that mask off his head. If they can prove who this is, if they can prove that it is Brian Pillman, Brian Pillman's career could be over. But the Yellow Dog, so far, he's escaped the grasp.
All right, your winners, the Yellow Dog, beatable Bobby, and Dustin Rhodes. And we'll have more after this timeout. What an exciting hour. They didn't get the mask off the Yellow Dog when they gave it every shot, didn't they?
Oh, it was exciting incorporated.
Okay. Next week, right here on Worldwide Wrestling, two big main events for you. First of all, with a world television title, Stunning Steve Austin will defend against Ron Simmons. In addition, next week, we will see a gigantic grudge match as Robert Gibson takes on Terrence Taylor of the York Foundation. Before we talk about the two main events, we have comments from Robert Gibson and from Terrence Taylor of the York Foundation.
You know, next week right here on this television program, Terry Taylor, I got you one-on-one. Let me tell you something. You're part of the York Foundation, Ricky Morton. Everybody in the world knows what you've done to me. Let me tell you something. To get to you, I have to go through Terrence Taylor and the whole York Foundation, guys. Be ready, because I'm coming.
Robert Gibson, you had to stick your nose where it didn't belong. So right here, next week on Worldwide Wrestling, I am going to take care of business. You crashed our welcoming party for Richard Morton. Now I am going to crash you.
It's going to be a great world television title matchup, but what about Robert Gibson and Terrence Taylor? A lot of implications when you talk about the York Foundation and Robert Gibson.
We know what a volatile situation that's become.
Yep.
And there's a lot of old bad blood now that's been brewed up because of things that have happened in the past. I can't wait to see what kind of confrontation they have.
You can better believe that Richard Morton and Mr. Hughes, as well as Alexander, will be there. We want you to be there also next week right here on Worldwide Wrestling. For Magnum TA, I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week with the Superstars of World Championship Wrestling.